Hello engineers! Today I'm back with a very small tutorial video about my docked ship script and what you can do with it and how it works. I will show you in a small tutorial. So let's get started. So first of all, you need basically three things. You need a program block and a timer block. And to show the information, you need an LCD panel. Maybe let's stick the panel right next to the program block. Okay. Yeah, let's wave a little. So next, you need to download my script, go to the program block, press edit, browse the workshop, search for my docked ship name script, hit OK, check code, and remember an exit. So then you need to set up the timer. The timer should run every 5 to 10 seconds. I will set it to 5 seconds here, and its actions should be run the program block with no argument and start itself again. Okay, what was the timer's name? Timer block docked ships. Sorry for that. So again, timer block docked ships and start. So for now that is everything we have to do, and if we hit start, the program is running. So we forgot one thing, and that is to assign the LCD panel to the script. So all we have to do is, now he says it, warning, LCD not found, LCD docked ships. By default the script looks for an LCD that is named LCD docked ships to show its information to. So let's name it that way. LCD docked ships. Okay. And as you see, the information is now shown on the LCD panel. And yeah, now you can see what my script does. It will show you all the connected or docked ships that are connected via a connector to your station. Now I have a small platform here with some ships, and yeah, the script will show you which ship is connected to which connector on my platform. So for example, there is the first ship, the drill drone, that is this one, and the drill drone is connected to the connector platform, this connector here. The connector is named connector platform. We can have a look here. Control panel, connector platform. So, and yeah, that way you can monitor all your docked ships. If you have a big hangar with several connectors and several ships, you can see which ship is connected to which connector. So, back in the script, you can modify some things here. At first, you can create groups or put individual connector names here if you want to only monitor certain connectors. For example, if I only want to monitor the connector platform, I can put its name here and check the code, remember an exit, and now only the connector platform is monitored. All the other connectors, even though they have ships on them, are not monitored by the script. As you see, this works for groups too. You can also group connectors together. So if you have a hangar with 6 connectors. You don't have to write every connector name here. You can just put the one group name here, and yeah, everything is done. Okay, but for now I will remove that. Next, you can show or hide information on the LCD. For example, the first one is show the connector name. If we go back to the LCD and look here, you see that at first the chip name is shown here and then the connector name. If you don't want that, you can set show connector name to false. And now, after the 5 seconds, only the chip names will be shown. Okay, and one last thing you can do is hide these numbers in front of the chip names if you don't like them. So go back to the script, press edit again. Here we have the show numbers value, and you can set this to false to hide the numbers in front of the chip names. And at last, you can also modify the LCD name you want to show the information to. As I said, by default, the script looks for an LCD that is named LCD docked chips. You can also group several LCDs together and put a group name here, or put other LCD names here divided by a comma. Like that. The newest feature I built into my script is the possibility to monitor specific connectors and show their status on specific LCD panels. So this is done via editing and modifying the custom data field of the LCD panel you want to show the information to. So, for example, on this LCD panel, I am monitoring the connector piston, that is this one, and the connector blank, that is this one, for a connection. And you see, on the connector piston sits my self-built spaceship named Falcon. And the connector blank has no ship docked, as you can see here. So to acquire these information, you need to go to the custom data field of the LCD panel. And this LCD panel does not have to be specified in the script itself. You only need to modify the custom data field, and the script will find it by itself. So let's go back here. We edit the custom data, and now you see the commands I put here. So first of all, I will remove everything. First of all, for the LCD to be noticed by the script, you have to put the keyword docked in here. So the keyword starts with an exclamation mark and then the word docked. If I only have this keyword here, you will see that the heading is there, but no information is shown because we didn't specify any connectors. So let's put a connector name here. You have to start a new line for every connector you want to monitor. So I put the keyword docked here, and then I press enter. And in the next line, I write down the first connector I want to monitor. For example, connector piston. Okay. And after a few seconds, the connector piston will show up with the connected Falcon on it. If I want to monitor more connectors, I have to create a new line for every connector I want to see on my LCD panel. For example, connector blank. We have connector platform. I know we have a connector platform too. And when I press OK now, the script will show all the connectors I put here in the custom data field. Another option you have is to modify the information that is shown here with some other keywords. For example, if I don't want the connectors to be shown here, but only the ships that are connected, there is the keyword. No. Connector name. Okay. And if you see, as you see, now all the connector names are gone, and only the ship's name, ship names stay on the LCD. So, we can also remove the numbers. So, edit it again. And write down no numbers. All of these keywords have to be in the first line where you wrote down docked. And they can be separated with everything, with a comma, with a semicolon or a space. That doesn't matter. Okay, and now all the numbers are gone. And if you want to show the information on corner LCD panels, there is another keyword that is very useful, and that's the keyword short. In short mode, the underline of the heading is gone, and everything is put into one line. So, for example, if I enable numbers and connector names again, I just remove it here, and I have now docked and short only. You can see that, yeah, everything is put into one line to fit perfectly for corner LCD panels, like you see above here. And yeah, that way you can have a small little corner LCD in front of every connector to see, yeah, what is connected to this specific connector at the time. For example, I have some LCD panels here. Currently docked chips, connector platform 2, that is this one, and it has the grasshopper on it, which is partly destroyed. And on this connector we have the drill drone. Yeah. So, that was my little tutorial video. I hope it was useful for you and you understood how to use my script. And if you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave a comment below in the Steam Workshop or on YouTube. I will try to help you as good as I can. So, for now, goodbye engineers, and have lots of fun with my script.